Hello and welcome to the 40th video in this beginner's guide to Adobe After Effects. In this tutorial, I'm going to demonstrate how you can build a complex layout and animate in After Effects. In the previous episode, we created the pin animation that appears at the start of the Hyde Park section. In this video, we are going to focus on the animation sequence that follows and builds up on top of the video. So let's get into it. So here I am, where we left off in the previous episode, where we created the pin animation that appears at the start of the Hyde Park section. Now, if you're watching for the first time and wish to follow along, you can find this document in the project folder, which you can download. Link is in the description. The download folder comes with lots of exercise documents we will be using on this course that have been carefully developed to aid your learning experience. The folder also comes with document resources such as videos, graphics, and images you can use to build your first video presentation from scratch later on in this course. To get the full learning experience, I recommend you get the project folder. Download link with instructions is in the description. With the project folder open, click into the S3 Create a Project folder, then click into folder 40, Build a Complex Layout, and open the Build a Complex Layout document. Now, if you are continuing on from the last episode, make sure you have your document open and ready. So, with our document open, let's proceed. Now, looking back at the Photoshop design, we can see a number of layers here. We have a title, subtitle, this decorative element here in the middle, and some type below. So what we are going to do next is look at how we can build this layout and add animation. So let's start by building the layout. Now looking back at the Photoshop design, we can see that the alignment of all these elements is down the center. So back in After Effects, I'll press Command colon on Mac or Control colon on PC to activate the guides. Now we should see the center guide down the center of the screen, which we created in an earlier episode. So I'll start by creating the top type layer. So I'll move my time indicator over into the next video edit so I have a clear screen. And I'll press Command T on Mac or Control T on PC to activate the type tool. And I'll click into the composition frame and type Hyde Park. Then I'll come over and click on the character panel, set the type to 170 and set the tracking to 40. I'll also click on the color box and make sure this is white. Next, I'll click on the paragraph panel and make sure my type is aligned to center. I'll click the selection tool and click and drag my type into the center and align it to my guide and place it towards the top of the frame, like so. Now, if for whatever reason you cannot see your bounding box, simply press Command-Shift-H on Mac or Control-Shift-H on PC. So with my new type layer selected, I'll come over to the colored square by the name, I'll click this and choose a green color. So with my title in place, I'll now create my subtitle. With the type layer selected, I'll press Command D on Mac or Control D on PC to duplicate the layer. I'll press V on the keyboard and move the type layer down like so. Now I'll paste in some new copy to replace this. So with the project folder open, click into folder 2, Project Assets, then click into the copy folder and open the presentation copy document. So here is the copy we are going to use for this presentation. So let's come up to the Hyde Park section and select the subheader copy, the stage of London's natural life. I'll copy this, then come back into After Effects. I'll begin by double-clicking on the new type layer to select it, and over in the character panel, I'll set the type size to 55 and increase the tracking to 100. Then I'll paste. So I'll click on the selection tool and I'll select the type layer and move it up and under the title, like so. Now looking back at the Photoshop design, we can see that there will be another type layer at the bottom. So while we are dealing with the type layers here, I'll create the next one. So just like before, with the type layer selected, press Command D on Mac or Control D on PC to duplicate the layer. I'll press V on the keyboard and move the type down like so. And now I'll paste in some new copy to replace this. So back in the copy document we just looked at, I'll come and select the next bit of copy below. So I'll copy this, then come back into After Effects, and I'll begin by double-clicking on the new type layer to select it, and over in the character panel, I'll set the type size to 33, and then I'll paste. So right now, the copy line is way too long, so I'll click into the type layer to place my cursor just in front of the word AND, and I'll press Enter to create a line break. Now, if the leading of the type is too wide,
I'll just double click on the type to select it all, and I'll come into the character panel and click and drag on the leading and set this to 50. And that is looking just like the original Photoshop design. Now, the issue we have here is that the white type on top of the video below is not quite as clear as it could be. What I'm going to do next is add a subtle gradient layer below, which will darken the video slightly and make the white type on top of the video pop a bit more. Okay, so I'll press F2 to make sure I have no layer selected in my timeline panel. Then I'll come up to the shape tool, I'll click and hold and select a rectangle tool. And I'll just come and click and draw a little rectangle shape like so. With my new shape layer created, I'll press Command-Alt-F on Mac or Control-Alt-F on PC to fit the shape to the entire canvas area. Perfect! With my shape now filling the screen, I'll come up to the top of the interface and click on the word Fill. Upon click, the Fill options will appear. From this option, I will select a Linear Gradient and click OK. Next, I'll come and click on the Square Color box, and this will pull up my Gradient Editor. So what I will do here is click the first gradient color and select a black. Then I'll select the next gradient color and select another black. Then I'm carefully going to come up to the gradient bar, and when the mouse cursor changes to the hand shape, I'll click once to add a new gradient color. With this active, I'll select a white color. So now we have a gradient here consisting of three colors, a black into white and the white into black. With this set, I'll click OK. With the selection tool active, I now need to pay close attention to the gradient handles on the shape. What I'll do here is carefully click and drag the left handle across close to the end of the screen, and then I'll drag the right handle close to the right edge of the screen, so I have a gradient effect that looks like this. So next, I'll come down into the timeline panel and come across to the left and look for my blending mode option. Now, if you cannot see the blending mode option, simply right-click on the column title, scroll down to columns, and come across and make sure Modes is ticked. So with the Modes option visible and my layer selected, I'll click on the Modes option and select Multiply. Upon click, we will now see the layer blending with the background. Next, I'm going to click and drag the new shape layer down below my type layers, and I'll press T to activate the opacity setting. I'll come down and drag the opacity down to 30%. So now we have a subtle linear vignette effect in the background. This will allow the type to pop just a little bit more on top of the video. So with the layer selected, I'll press enter, and this will allow me to change the name of the layer, and I'll call it Gradient Overlay, and press enter. Next, I'll click on the colored square for this layer and choose a purple color. Now, there is one more thing we can do to the type to make it more clear and readable. So I'll select the middle type layer to select the subheader, then I'll come over and click on the Effects and Presets panel. With it visible, I'll come up to the top and type in Drop. This will reveal the drop shadow effect in the Perspective folder. So now I can click and drag this drop shadow effect from the Effects and Presets panel and down onto my type layer. Upon release, I will see my effect controls over on the left. So I'll come over and set the opacity to 60%. I'll tweak the direction so the angle is directly below. I'll set the distance to 7 and set the softness to 10. So now we have a nice drop shadow on the subheader, and the type is just a little bit more clear on top of the background video. So now I'm going to apply the same effect to this type below. So I'll select the top type layer, which will select the bottom type layer in the composition panel, and drag the drop shadow effect from the effects and presets panel and down onto my type layer. Upon release, I will see my effect controls over on the left. So I'll come over to this, set the opacity to 60%, I'll tweak the angle so it's directly below, I'll set the distance to 7, and set the softness to 10, and now we have a nice drop shadow on the bottom type. Perfect! Now looking back at the Photoshop design, we can see in between the type we have these visual elements, a swan image with two bars either side. So back in After Effects, let's place these into the comp. But first, we need to have clear visibility of the project panel. So I'll come over to the panel here, and at the top right corner of the panels, we have these two arrows pointing out right. If we click this, we can see we click back on the project panel. So now, with the project folder open, click into Folder 2, Project Assets, then click into the Image folder, then click into the AI folder, then into the Location Specific folder, and you will see some Illustrator documents here. So I'll click on the Swan document and just drag it into After Effects into the project panel like so. I'll come back to the project folder and click on the bar document and again drag it into After Effects into the project panel. So now I have the swan and the bar asset in my project panel. With these two files now in the project, let's drop down the assets folder so I can see the vectors folder in the images folder. And I'll drop the two new files into the vector folder like so. So I'll start here with the swan image. So with it selected in the project panel, I'll press Command/ on Mac or Control/ on PC to quickly place the comp layer into my main comp. With my new layer in the timeline, I'll come down and right click on the layer. I'll scroll to create and click Create Shapes from Vector Layer. Upon click, we will see a new shape layer appear in the timeline panel. For now, I can click the original swan layer below and just delete it as I will not be needing it any longer. So I'll click back on my new swan shape layer. I'll come up to the top of the interface and click on the fill color box and set this to a white color and click OK. So now I have my white swan, but right now it's a little too big. So I'll press S to reveal the scale settings for the layer. I'll come down and drag the scale to 35%, and then I will drag the swan down in between the subheader and the bottom type layer. With the layer selected, I'll press Enter, and this will allow me to change the name of the layer, and I'll call it Swan and press Enter. Next, I'll click on the colored square for the layer and choose a purple color. So that's the swan image in my comp. Now I'm going to follow the same procedure, though for my bar graphic. So with the bar asset selected in the project panel, I'll press Command/ on Mac or Control/ on PC to quickly place into my main comp. With my new layer in the timeline, I'll come down, right click on the layer, I'll scroll to create and click Create Shapes from Vector Layer. Upon click, we will see a new shape layer appear in the timeline panel. Now I can click the original bar layer below and just delete it as I will not be needing that any longer. So I'll click back on my new bar shape layer. I'll come up to the top of the interface and click on the fill color box and set this to a white color and click OK. So now I have my white bar, but right now it's a little too big. So I'll press S to reveal the scale settings for the layer and I'll come down and drag on the scale setting to 60%. I'll press V to activate the selection tool and drag the bar down and to the right of the swan here. With the layer selected, I'll press Enter and I'll name the bar Bar Right and press Enter. Next, I'll click on the color square for the layer and choose a purple color. Now, with the layer selected, I'll press Command D on Mac or Control D on PC to duplicate the layer. And with the selection tool, I'll drag it over to the left while holding Shift to drag it smoothly over like so. With the layer selected, I'll press Enter, and I'll name the layer Bar Left and press Enter. Next, I'll click the colored square on the layer and I'll choose a purple color. So that's all the elements in the composition done. What I will do now is just make sure the layout is correct and balanced. So with the selection tool, I'll just click on the top header here and move it up like so. I'll click on the bottom type and move up, and click on all the other elements and carefully move them up and down until I get a nice balanced layout that looks like this. Now I'll also jump back into Photoshop to look at the design to make sure I've positioned all the elements in the right place. So once I'm happy with the layout, I'll press Command:\ on Mac or Control:\ on PC to turn off the guides. And once I'm happy with the layout, I can start to think about animating the layers. Now, if I drag my time indicator over to the start of the comp, we can see all the layers are visible. So at this point, we don't want this. What we want are the layers to start to animate in right after the pin drops. So now I'll carefully drag my time indicator just after where the pin drops away. I'll select the top layer, hold Shift and select the type layer just above the gradient overlay layer. We don't want to select the gradient layer here, just the layers above. And with them selected, I'll press Alt open bracket, and that will trim the start of the layers. So what we're going to do now is animate the type layers, keeping in mind that they're going to appear in at different times. So let's start with the transparency transitions. So I'll press F2 to deselect all the layers. Then select the swan layer, press and hold Shift and select the top type layers. With them selected, I'll press T to activate the opacity settings. With the time indicator at the start of the layers, I'll come down and click the stopwatch, and this will add the first opacity keyframe for each layer. So next, I'll drag my time indicator across a little like so, and hit the diamond icon to add a second opacity keyframe to each. So now I have two keyframes for opacity. Next, I'll drag my time indicator towards the start of the layers holding shift to snap. And with the time indicator perfectly over my first set of opacity keyframes, I'll click and drag the opacity to zero. Now, if I scrub my time indicator over my frames, we can see the type and the swan shape fades in, like so. So now what I want to do is position the layers across time so the transition happens differently. So I'll press F2 to deselect the layers, and I'll start by clicking on the middle type layer. So what I'll do here is click and drag the layer so the first keyframe meets the second keyframe for the type layer below. Then I'll select the type layer above and just drag it further across, like so. Next, I'll select the swan layer above and drag it further across to match the type layer below. For now, we don't need to worry about these two layers. Next, I'm going to select the two bar layers above and drag them down on top of the middle type layer, like so. Then I'll drag them to the end of the last keyframe of the second type layer. So now if I scrub my time indicator over the sequence, we can see that the title appears first, then straight after the subheader, and then the bars. And if we continue to move the time indicator, the swan and the last bit of type appear after that. So that's the opacity transition applied. All that's left to do is apply the scale transition to the title. Now, as the title fades in, I also want it to scale up. So I'll drag my time indicator back to the second keyframe of the Hyde Park type layers while holding shift to snap. With the type layer selected, I'll pay close attention to the anchor point that is currently applied to the type. For this layer, we want the anchor point to be set right at the baseline and in the center. Now, if your anchor point is not set at the baseline, simply come up to the Tools menu and select the Anchor Point tool. With the Anchor Point tool selected, you can click and drag the anchor point on your layer like so, to set a new place. For this layer, I want to set it right at the bottom on the baseline and positioned in the center like so. So with the type layer selected, I'll press S to activate the scale settings for the layer, and I'll come down and click on the stopwatch to add a scale keyframe. Next, I'll press U until the keyframes are revealed, and I'll drag my time indicator back to the first keyframe while holding shift to snap. And I'll click the diamond icon to add a new keyframe for scale. So right now I cannot see the type, because the opacity at this moment is set to zero. What I'll do is come and drag the scale down to 20%. Now as I scrub my time indicator over the keyframe sequence, we can see the title fades in and zooms up. Then the subtitle appears just after that, and the bars after that. Perfect. So I'll place my time indicator at 5 seconds, and press N to set the end of the workspace area. I'll click into the work area and press spacebar to activate preview. So this is now starting to come together nicely. We have the pin animation and the layout starting to build. So what we're going to do next is the last part of the animation sequence. Next, we are going to focus on the animation that happens to the bars. To animate the bars in like this, we are going to use a mask. In the next video, we are going to apply masks to the bar layers and animate the mask so we can create this nice animation effect where they appear to draw in. Once applied, this will finish the animation sequence for this section. So see you in the next video.